Hello, you're on Public Spot, I'm George. Welcome to this new series on setting up infrastructure foundations with Terraform and AWS. On this episode, I'll show you how I write Terraform code to build a foundation of a private cloud network in AWS. I'll create Terraform module that will set up my VPC and all underlying resources I need to set up a public subnet. So, if this episode and this channel lines up with your interests, click the subscribe button and join me in the journey of learning by doing. So, let's start coding. I'll start with a very bare minimum set of infrastructure resources to set up a virtual private cloud in AWS. So I'll cd to my workspace projects directory from here. I'll create a new directory where I'll put all my infrastructure code. And then I'll cd to this new directory and then run git init to initialize my local git repository. I'll need to rename my default trunk to main and then launch my Visual Studio Code from this directory. I will be doing most of the work on my Visual Studio Code, so let me switch to that. I need to set a pre-commit hook on this project so I could automatically validate my code when I commit my changes. So I'll create a new directory here called hooks. And then I'll create my pre-commit hook script. And then I will set the hooks path on my Git configuration. So let me launch my terminal from my VS Code. And then in here, I'll run this command. And then I'll stage and then commit the initial set of changes that I've done. Launch my Git graph. And then it shows my first commit on my local repository. Before we proceed, let me close all these windows and close my Explorer. I have a very, very simple script that creates initial set of Terraform config files for me. I'll add a link on the description below so you can have a look at what it does. But if I want to initialize my set of Terraform config files, I'll run this. Command completed successfully. Now, if I open my VS Code Explorer, what you will notice are this new set of Terraform configuration files created for me automatically. This is how I'd like to structure my Terraform configuration files, but what I would like to point out is the providers.tf. You'll notice that my AWS provider is set automatically with a region based on an input variable. So this defines the AWS region that my infrastructure will be created in, and the selection of the region will depend on a number of factors. And the most common of these considerations are latency and compliance requirement. So first, the closer the AWS region you select to you or to your customers, the better. However, if you've got compliance requirements like GDPR, this may require you to set your infrastructure in a specific region. So now let me open my main.tf and start writing the Terraform code for the resources that I need. So I'll start with the VPC resource. I need this VPC to be able to resolve virtual machines and DNS within its network. So I need to enable properties like DNS hostnames and DNS support. And then to set the VPC, I need to assign this resource a CIDR block and assign the value using a variable input. I'm using a variable to populate the property CIDR block. So I need to put a definition for this variable in my variables.tf. I won't be setting a default value for this variable to make it a required input. Let me go back to my main.tf. The last property that I need to add to my AWS VPC resource is tags to allow me to identify this resource when I log into my web console. So I need to add a tag entry to identify all related resources. So I need some kind of a resource identifier variable, which I'll set later on. So let me adjust this screen. What I have here for the tags property is a merge of a predefined set of local tags, which I've set in my locals.tf. And then if you go back to main.tf, I'm also setting a name tag for my VPC using a variable called resource identifier. So I need to go to my variables.tf and define this variable. I'll set a default value for this variable and call it default. That's all I have to do for my VPC resource. Now I'll save all my changes, stage my changes, and then commit to my local repository. Now, I'll move to the next set of resources to set up public subnet. First thing I'll do is set up the resources that would allow my VPC access to the internet, and that's the internet gateway. This resource is pretty straightforward, so I just need to set up the reference to the VPC that I just created. I also need to add tags on this resource, setting the name tag using the same resource identifier that I use for my VPC. Now I'll save all my changes and commit to my local repository. The next set of resources to write code for is the route table resource, which will store all the routing rules for the VPC. Like the internet gateway, this is also very straightforward, and it simply needs to have a reference to the VPC resource. So let's go ahead and add that. And like all the other resources that I've created so far, I need to set a tag for this resource with the same name set using the resource identifier. Now I'll save my changes and then commit it to my local repository. I noticed something strange whenever I commit my changes to my local repository. The pre-commit hook that I've set earlier does not seem to be running, and I think I know why this is the case, so let's go ahead and fix it. I need to make my pre-commit script executable, so now let me go ahead and commit this change into my local repository. And now we're getting the error of a missing binary reference. It says no version set for command Terraform. And to fix this, I need to run asdf local on this directory. And then this creates my tool versions file, and so I need to commit that change as well. This error is complaining about the pre-commit script, so let's go ahead and open that script and see what's wrong. So it looks like the recursive switch is missing a dash, and the backend switch is also missing a dash. Let me save those changes and then stage and commit my changes. Now my pre-commit hook is working properly, and it has actually returned some validation errors on my Terraform config that I need to fix. So let's go ahead and have a look. There's one error in there, and it's complaining about misspelled local tags. So let's go ahead and fix that. Save my changes, stage and commit this change. So my pre-commit checks are clean. So let me go ahead and move to the next resource that I need to set up. So the next resource to write is the route resource to allow inbound and outbound access to the internet from the VPC. So this is essentially where I tell my internet gateway to point everywhere and add that routing rule to the route table resource I created previously. So let me go to my main.tf. So what I have set up here is an AWS route resource, which will be an entry in my route table. And the destination of the traffic is the internet, which is designated by this notation. And then this resource will utilize the internet gateway as the gateway for the outbound request. In my experience, this resource normally takes a little bit of time to create. So I'll add a timeout block on this resource to allow more time for the creation. So I'll set a timeout value to about 5 minutes. And then now I need to stage my changes and then commit to my local repository. So everything looks clean so far. And so what I need to create next is the subnet resource. But before I do that, bear in mind that there are two types of subnets, a public subnet and a private subnet. And public subnet resources provide a space to allocate virtual machines that are accessible from the internet, whereas private subnet resources provide a space to allocate virtual machines that are accessible only from inside the VPC. So let me go ahead and create the public subnet resource and associate this with the VPC resource that I created earlier. I need to set a property for this resource to assign public IPs to virtual machines that are allocated in this subnet automatically. So let's go ahead and create that resource. A well-architected infrastructure involves setting up multiple subnets across availability zones. And so your availability zones would be your different data centers. So what I need to do is set a variable that will accept a list of applicable CIDR blocks for my public subnets. And then I will loop through each CIDR block entry on this variable to create multiple public subnets and assign each entry to the cider block property for the subnet. So let's go ahead and update this resource. And then now I need to update my variables.tf for the definition of my public subnets variable. I will not be setting a default value for this variable to make it a required input. I also need to set a facility to distribute my public subnets to different availability zones. Having more than one availability zone allows for redundancy and high availability of infrastructure. So firstly, I need to fetch all available zones that I can use by setting a data reference. So let me open my data.tf, and then in here, I'll create a data reference to all AWS availability zones. So let me go to my locals.tf, and then in here, I'll slice the availability zones based on the number of desired availability zones provided as a variable. Now I need to set the definition of the new variable called availability zone count into my variables.tf and set the default value to 1. Now I need to update my public subnet block, and then I need to set the availability zone property by picking up a value from the list of availability zones that I've defined earlier as a local parameter. So let me go back to my main.tf. And then I need to add the tag property to this resource. We know that we have two types of subnets, so I need to make sure that I can quickly identify the resources as public subnets. So I need to update the name property in my tag to add the string public, and then concatenate a running counter to make sure that I have different names for each public subnet. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to change this and set it to format. So now I need to save all my changes, stage all of them, and then commit to my local repository. So my pre-commit script has failed and nothing has been committed to my local repository, and that's because we have an error with my Terraform code. Save that change, stage the change, and then commit to my local repository. The final part of completing my public subnet setup is to plug in the routing table in each public subnet. So what I need to do is I need to loop through each public subnet and attach the route table. Now I'm going to save my changes, stage it, and then commit to my local repository. So now I need to persist my local repository into my GitHub account. So let me switch to my browser and access GitHub. And then I'll create a new repository. And then on this page, I'll scroll down to the section where it tells me the steps to sync up my local repository. And then I'll copy this command, switch back to my VS Code, and then run that command. And then I need to run a push command to sync up my local repository with the remote repository. So the push command failed. And this is because I'm trying to push everything that's inside this directory to GitHub, which includes the Terraform context created when my pre-commit hook runs Terraform in it. So what I need to do is create a git ignore file and add all files and directories that I need to be ignored when I push everything to Git. Now I need to save my changes, stage them, and then commit to my local repository. So now I want to try running git push again to sync up my local repository with my remote repository. My git push has completed successfully. Now if I switch to my browser and refresh this page, all my local changes have synced up successfully to this remote repository. That's it for now. Watch out for the next episode where I extend this module by adding infrastructure code for private subnets. And in the meantime, let me know your thoughts and send me some likes if you find this useful. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date with the new videos on this channel. Until next time, see ya.